Simon & Schuster Audio presents A Noob's Diary of an 8-Bit Warrior, Book 1 in the Noob's Diary series, by Cube Kid, read by Michael Gallagher.
Monday. Welcome to our village. Around here, we're defenseless against creatures. Well, against monsters, to be more specific. They come every night, and all we can do is hide in our little houses. If only we could fight them. Sadly, villagers aren't allowed to. I live in a village of scaredy cats. We've built high walls to protect ourselves from monsters. They're everywhere at night, and we like to stay safe and scared in our homes instead of facing them. It's ridiculous. I'd rather fight, face these monsters so they finally leave us alone. But nobody takes me seriously in the village. One of the reasons why is my name. Why did my parents think calling me Runt was a good idea? With that kind of name, of course everyone thinks I'm a noob. But if I could battle a monster, they'd finally see me as I really am, a warrior. But sadly, villagers never become warriors. All they care about is staying safe, cooped up in the village, and earning emeralds. Everyone tells me that I should be a farmer like my parents, have a good job worthy of a villager. But I dream of more. Steve is my idol. He's a warrior, and he's so cool. He's got style and a diamond sword he can defeat any monster with. That's so much cooler than being a farmer, isn't it? I'm still far away from that dream. I can't stand the thought of becoming a farmer. I want to be a warrior just like Steve. But villagers never become warriors. This morning, I made a huge mistake at school. We were doing a really simple mining exercise, but I forgot to repair my pickaxe. Of course, it broke and went flying toward the teacher's head. Luckily, he wasn't hurt. But my pride wasn't as lucky. The whole class made fun of me. Runt the Noob strikes again. This afternoon, we had the only cool class of the week, mob defense. "Today, we're going to study Endermen," the teacher said. All the other students shivered. Not me. I was excited. "They're dangerous creatures that will attack you if you look them in the eye," she continued. "Despite that, warriors hunt them down for those very eyes. That's because an eye of Ender can open a portal to the end, the dragon's lair." I took meticulous notes. I learned this super fancy word in class yesterday. It means something like careful. To be honest, I pay more attention and I focus more in this class than anywhere else.
"What are villagers supposed to do if we run into an Enderman?" the teacher asked.
Max, a kid in class who likes making fun of me, said we should sell him pants because with legs that long, we'd make a lot of emeralds. Of course, everyone laughed, except me. This is a serious topic. I couldn't help myself. "No, we attack them. We attack them," I yelled. The teacher covered her mouth in shock.
"None of that. Attack an Enderman? Never. If you see one, run. Do you hear me, Runt?"
Everyone looked at me and laughed. None of them think I could be a warrior. And I'm going to prove them all wrong. I'm tired of it. That was it. I decided to get out of there that night. My friend Stump didn't think it was a good idea.
"We're not allowed to leave the village, Runt," he said.
I told him it would be fine, that Steve had taught me how to craft a wooden sword when he was last here. Stump thinks I'm such a noob, but I know how to defend myself.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.